يثبت الله الذين آمنوا بالقول الثابت في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة.
The tarjama, a mujaza, a summarized biography of the author of this book and his lineage. His name is Ali ibn Umar ibn Ahmad ibn Mahdi ibn Mas'ud ibn al-Uthman ibn al-Nu'man ibn Dinar ibn Abdullah Abu al-Hasan. So his name is Ali ibn Umar. Imam Al Daraqutni, his name is Ali ibn Umar, is his name. His name is Ali and his dad's name is Umar. His kunya is Abu al-Hasan. Abu al-Hasan is his kunya. Wa Daraqutniyyu. Daraqutniyyu bi fathi dali wa sukuni ta'i al-muhmala. So what do? We place a fatha on the dal and we place a sukun on the ta'. Ad-Daraqutni. Nisbatan ila darul qutn is an attribution to a big place. Mahalla kabira kanat fi Baghdad. It was a big place that used to be in Baghdad. And the word qutn, I know you should all know, is wool. Wool. So it was a place, Daraqutn, it was a building, place, big place that used to be in Baghdad, that they used to make the wool. Wulida rahimahullah, al-imam al-Daraqutni rahimahullah, he was born when the year was what? Sanata sittin wa thalathimi'ah, 306 Hijriah. When the Islamic calendar was 306 Hijriah, he rahimahullah, he was born then. Ijtahada fi talab al-ilmi min sigarihi. The Sheikh, he strived and he worked hard in gaining knowledge from a very young age. Allahu Akbar. And we always say this point, which is al-ilmu fi sigari kan naqshi ala al-hajari. Knowledge at a young age is like carving into a rock. And wal ilm, and knowledge fil kibari, and knowledge in an old age is kal kitabati ala al ma, is like writing on water. Sah? When you try to memorize when you're young, sponge. It's like the kids' brain is amazing. But try to memorize something when you're old, it becomes very hard. So he, rahimahullah, from a very young age, he started to seek knowledge and to strive. And you know, brothers, as Imam Shafi'i said, لَنْ تَلَالَ الْعِلْمَ إِلَّا بِسِتَّةٍ سَأُنْبِيكَ عَنْ تَفْصِيلِهَا بِبَيَانِ ذَكَاءٌ وَحِرْصٌ وَاجْتِهَادٌ. Ijtihad. If you're not striving, you're not going to learn. And we always mention the statement that Imam Muslim in Kitab al-Muwaqit, he brings mu'allaqan, the statement of Yahya ibn Abi Kathir, which is لا ينال العلم براحة الجسد. Knowledge is not gained with a body that is relaxed. And I've said this before and I repeat it many times. Two things cannot work together. They cannot. Just like water and fire can't be together. They can't. And that is what? Being relaxed and seeking knowledge. They are two things that can't work. One would have to take the place. And you would have to choose from the two of them. Once you want to learn and you want to gain knowledge, you are going to see that your sleep, you're going to be deprived from sleeping. You're going to be deprived from eating. If you look at the tarjama, the biography of the scholars, you find that the time that they hated the most was times of eating. And you see, they didn't like eating. They hated sleeping. You see, some of them, they forgot marriage. You see, it's because their brain and their mind was preoccupied. This is what it was for them. So this is how he was, Al-Imam Daraqutni. From a very young age, he had passion and a drive and an enthusiasm for knowledge. وَوَهَبَهُ اللَّهُ ذَكَاءً. You see, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gave him He was very smart, intellectual. And my beloved brothers and sisters, one of the things that shows a person smart and he's dhaki, smart is knowing to prioritize. That's dhaka. Knowing to prioritize. Subhanallah, just today, I watched a clip of a professor in the States teaching his students. He took a jar. He took a jar and he put inside the jar tennis balls. When he put tennis balls inside the jar, he asked the students, he said to the students, "Is the jar full?" And they said, "Yes, it's full." And then he took black seed, dry black seeds. And then he poured it inside the jar again and it would go in. And he said to them, "Is it full?" And they said, "Yes." And then he went and he put sand inside there. And then he said to them, "Is it full?" And they said, "Yes." So three times they were saying it was full, but he was able to put more things in there. And he said something to them. He said, "If I was to put the sand in there first, I would never have been able to put in the golf balls. Nor would I have been able to put in, and nor would I have been able to put in the black seeds, the dry black seeds." And that shows you is the sand is the smallest in size. Don't preoccupy yourself and your time with things that are insignificant, that are little, with big things that you need to achieve. And that you focus and you prioritize. It was truly very important. That message was very powerful. And that's why Shafi'i preceded him in this. He said, "Ya akhi, lan tanala al-ilma illa bi sittatin sa'unbika an tafsiriha bi bayani." Dhaka'un. He mentioned the first one, you have to be dhaki. You have to be very smart. You have to be clever. You should know that when others are gone, and other people are playing, and other people are joking, and other people are wasting their time arguing, you're not about that. For you, it's about every lahva, every minute, I'm here going to benefit. You could sit there, criticize, critique, benefit. I'm not about that. My time means a lot to me, that I will benefit from it, and I will study, and I will nurture myself with understanding. I'm not going to be how I was yesterday. I'm not going to be today. That's smart. That's dhiki. وَحِفْظًا. And he was also a person of memorization. Imam, he memorized. ولذلك, this book of his, العلل الواردة, his book, العلل الواردة, Imam Al Daraqutni, rahimahullah, it was said, his book, العلل الواردة, Daraqutni, it was said that he dictated it from the top of his head. And Imam الذهبي in his Sira ala min Nubala, he said, if Sira ala min Nubala, Imam al-Dhahabi says this. He says it in the 16th volume, page 449. He says, if this is true, that Daraqutni dictated his book Al-Ilal al-Warida from the top of his head, then his memorization is at the caliber of Imam Ahmed and Imam al-Bukhari. He's of that caliber. And without a doubt, he did dictate that book of his from the top of his head. Wallahi, when you look at it, it is an ujuba. It is volumes. I think it's 36 volumes. Dar al-Tayyiba published it. Ilal, he's been asked. Defects. And as I said before, ilmul hadith revolves around ilal. And al-ilal is ghamid, is something very hidden. You see? He was one who had that knowledge. Riwayat and ruwat and narrators. He was an imam in this particular field.
Daraqutni, Imam al-Ilal. By the way, Daraqutni, he has a kitab called Ilal al-Warida. They said, Amlahu min dhahrihi. And Amlahu min hifdhihi. He narrated the whole entire 10 something volumes. Yani from memory. Al-Dhahabi, I think it was him. He said that if it's true, I think it was Imam al-Dhahabi. He said, if it's true that Daraqutni dictated this book from memory, that he's no less than Ahmed Muhammad and Abu Zur'at al-Razi and Amatim al-Razi. By the way, they said about Daraqutni as a side benefit. They said about him, subhanAllah, they said about him, he would yani put things in his ears when he walked outside. Because okay. He would memorize people's conversations.
Oh, his memory was that sharp.
Sharp. There was a strange story that was mentioned about Imam Daraqutni. This is a side point.
Yeah.
They said that two men were arguing, uh-huh. and they were speaking a different language.
Okay.
And he saw the argument going back and forth, and he had his cotton wool in his ears. He chose to take it out and came to the two people. And he said, "What is the problem? What's the quarrel that you guys are having?" And they told him their problems. Later, both of them went. And they went to the court to argue. The court said, "Well, who's your witness in this situation?" They said, "Daraqutni is our shahid witness. He was there. He was present when we were both arguing. He was there." Keeping in mind that Daraqutni, they were quarreling and they were arguing in two different languages. So he came to the courtroom and the judge asked, "Daraqutni, is it true? Is it true that you were present when these two people were arguing over an issue?" He said, "Yes." What did they say to each other? He said, "They spoke different language. Both of them were speaking two different languages. I don't know what they said, but I memorized it." He quoted this first man what he said. He quoted the second one what he said. And he kept the information for them intact. Passed it on. The qadi said, "We know what he meant, what happened."
Allahu Akbar.
Gave the judgment to this. So Daraqutni rahimahullah ta'ala, they said his hifdh was thaqib, and strong, solid.
قَلَّ أَن يُوجَدَ فِي أَحَدٍ. It was very little you would find the memorization that Imam Daraqutni had to find it in anybody. Brothers and sisters, what we need to understand is these scholars, when they took knowledge from the land which they were in, they always traveled. So he stayed in Baghdad. This is where he's from. So he heard from the scholars of Baghdad, and he took the knowledge from the ulama of Baghdad. And then he went to other cities in Iraq, like Kufa, and he went to Basra, and he went to Wasit, he went to Sham, he went to Egypt. And his ulama and the shuyukh that he took knowledge from are very large in amount. And anybody who reads an Imam Daraqutni's books will know his mashayikh and his ulama. Al-Imam al-Khatib al-Baghdadi in his kitab Tariq al-Baghdad. Al-Imam al-Khatib al-Baghdadi in his book Tariq al-Baghdad, he said the following about Imam al-Daraqutni. He said the following. He said, "Kana farida asrihi. وقريع دهره ونسيج وحده وإمام وقته انتهى إليه أثر انتهى إليه علم الأثر والمعرفة بعلل الحديث وأسماء الرجال وأحوال الرواة مع الصدق والأمانة والفقه والعدالة وقبول الشهادة وصحة الاعتقاد وسلامة المذهب والاطلاع بعلوم سوى علم الحديث علم الحديث." خطيب البغدادي said, Al-Imam al-Daraqutni was unique at his time. He was a rare person, rahimahullah, who stuck out, who was seen with distinct characteristics and attributes. And he was the Imam of his time. He was the end point of ilm al-athar and ma'rifatu ilal al-hadith, knowing the defects of narrations and hadiths. Wa asma' al-rijal, and knowing the men and the narrators. Wa ahwal al-ruwat, and situations pertaining to narrations. Whether it be sidq and amana, being trustworthy, or narration not being taken from them. Also fiqh and adala. He was also a person whose knowledge of hadith and was powerful. Also fiqh. Not only that, وقبول الشهادة وصحة الاعتقاد. His aqeeda was good. Al-Imam al-Daraqutni, he had the aqeeda to Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah. وسلامة المذهب, his madhab and his methodology was pure and it was clean. والاطلاع, and he also had read and researched and studied بعلوم سوى علم الحديث. He also read books in other than علم الحديث. He has a book in علم القراءات. He has a book in قراءات. He authored a book in Qiraat. He was an imam in that field as well. Imam al-Daraqutni, rahimahullah, he was praised by a lot of a'immah. Al-Imam Abu Hakim, Naysaburi praised him. Al-Imam al-Dhahabi praised him. Ibn al-Jawzi praised him. Khatib al-Baghdadi here we can see praised him. He's an imam that has been testified and been like everyone has unanimously agreed upon ala jalalati wa makanati, how high and how noble he is. Al-Imam Al-Daraqutni left behind books. From those books is his Sunan Al-Daraqutni, and Ilal Al-Warida, which I said that he dictated from the top of his head. He also has a book called Al-Mu'talif wal-Mukhtalif, which is a particular field of science of hadith, which scholars in Mustalah al-Hadith deal with. He authored a book in that particular field. And he has books other than that. He also has books in aqeeda. And from the books that he has written in aqeeda that we know of are three. There are three books that he has written in aqeeda. He has written this book that we have with us today, which is Kitab al-Sifat. And the second book that he has written is Kitab al-Nuzul, which he talks about Allah tabarak wa ta'ala descending. Kitab al-Nuzul. And the third book that he has written is Kitab al-Ru'ya, that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will be seen the Day of Judgment. That Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will be seen the Day of Judgment. So he has these three books, Kitab al-Sifat, Kitab al-Nuzul, and Kitab al-Ru'ya. They are in the field of aqeedah. Al-Imam al-Daraqutni, as Ibn al-Jawzi mentions in his Muntadham, that he died, rahimahullah, the last day of Yawm al-Thulatha, when it was the 7th of Dhul Qa'dah, and the year was 385. So he died at the age of what? 79. He died at the age of 79. Rahimahullah. So 79 and 2 days. Rahimahullahu rahmatan wasi'ah.